have to remind me, because I be so many places. I started to say Pensacola, Mobile, Alabama. Jazzy Red Talk Show, and I'm your host, Jazzy Red. If you all was seen the Peggy's party, you seen this lady here, Miss Lady Ebony. And she had said she was going to give us an interview and maybe sing for us, but we're going to interview her today. Lady Ebony, how are you doing?
I'm well, and yourself?
All right. This is a young lady that do a lot. I'm going to let her tell you what she's singing. Tell them what you do.
Well, right now, I'm doing Southern Soul. I'm doing a little bit of contemporary. I'm doing a little bit of acoustic. So we got a little bit of different flavors going on for everybody out there.
She's high energy. She's also a writer, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all are going to be looking for a book. Me and her going to connect today because y'all know I got one published, so I'm going to be helping her out. I own a publishing company, so I'm going to put her some prints on. My thing is, it don't matter what company you get, I want to make sure that you're copywritten. That's the first thing. You got to get your book copywritten. But tell them a little something about you.
Well, I started singing when I was a little girl, about 5 years old, in the church. I've always had a passion for music. I did clarinet, I did keyboard, I tried to trickle in guitar, but it didn't work out right away, so I'm trying to get back in there right about now. But other than that, I do writing. I write poetry, I do songwriting, and I'm also writing, like she was saying, writing my book called Facing War, and just look out for that. That is due coming soon. I want to say more of a public speaker, because I do talking up to other people, to other kids, about domestic violence, and as well as I have a 16-year-old brother that I'm raising. He was in a situation where he was with his mom and violence was going on in the household. So I also try to speak out a little bit more about that, and seeing and going into the situation with him and trying to get him out of the mentality of hurt. So I've been doing a lot of things with that as well. So
okay. Domestic violence is gotta go away. It gotta go away. You can't get along. Just get away from each other. Take the plan and say, okay, this half your house, this my half, and somebody gotta go.
Yes.
That's just it. Somebody gotta go.
Yes.
And because it's a problem. We're hurting each other and killing each other in domestic violence. And that has to go away. And a man don't supposed to beat on a woman. A real man can put a woman take her hand and hold both of her wrists. That's really what you can do. But you will get some kicks sometime, too. But y'all got to stop that. That got to go away, man. That got to go away. What sparked you? You want domestic violence to go away, right?
Yes. Well, I myself, when I was a little girl and as a teenager, I was sexually abused, which is kind of what sparked my writing of the book, as well as when I was 21, I got into an incident where me and my stepfather got into a physical altercation where we got into a physical fight, and it just went left field, and then come down with my brother and his mom and different things like that. So that really just took it overboard when I seen the situation with my brother. I mean, throughout my years, I'm 25, and throughout my years, everything that I've seen and had to deal with, I've dealt with other women that goes through the same things, and I see how they handle their relationships. Even now, I have a couple friends that are in relationships, and they don't even realize just how domestic it is for them. Like, they fight with each other. They're in and out of jail. The guy is in and out of jail, or the woman is in and out of jail. Or you have this mental capacity where they're mentally violating these women. So it's just a lot of things going on that really makes me want to just go out there and speak and be an advocate for other women.
And you got to do it. Y'all ladies, y'all got to stop. I wrote in my book how men are tell ladies things like, you're too fat, you're too skinny, you're too light, you're too dark, you're dumb, you can't read, you don't know right, you can't do math, you ain't working. I don't listen to that, man. I tune that. I can't deal with that. I have to be alone, because I'm not going to listen to anything negative. On my job, I'm a welder, and I'd rather just have my shield down and weld. I think I'll buy a welding machine if I was married. I've been married twice. I just put the machine down and burn his ass. You know what I'm saying? Just go to work. You know, nobody wants to live with that, man. It's a desperate thing. Nobody wants to be bothered with problems. No problems. I don't like problems. I get away from problems. Gas the car up and let's go to Florida then, okay? that's right. It's a good thing that she's a young sister and she doing a lot of things that I want you to let up. I mean, you just gotta keep doing. If you got a phone number where they can get in touch. I see your mom is here with you. You and her get along pretty good, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Me and my mom, if my mom was alive, we'd be arm wrestling right now about the camera, you know. But I see they get along. They were talking, and I've got Latoria Jackson book, and she said her father was so mean to her that she didn't know that fathers hug their children. They used to think when the father come home, you had to go. Michael say, if they were visiting, they said, we got to go because they daddy coming. And then they see that somebody, father hugging them, they would say, did you see that? That's odd. He was hugging them. Till they found out that's really the way it's supposed to go. Yeah. So you can be inside of an abusive home,
yes,
father or mother or wife and husband, and you think that's the way this stuff's supposed to go. It don't supposed to go that way. Ladies and gentlemen, not supposed to go that way. I want to commend you for helping and trying to straighten things out in 25 years old. Ain't that something, ladies and gentlemen? She going to conquer the world when she get my age. I ain't telling you my age. All right. You got a phone number. Have you got a phone number?
I do not have a personal phone number, but I do have a booking number, 850-293-2063. You can contact on that number. You can text. You can email as well, edwenterprises.com, or you can go on ladyebony.com, and you can put in, we do have an area that you can communicate, or you can put in your email addresses to where we can communicate back and forth. I'll be starting a blog soon to where I'll be able to actually talk to the women, okay, through the site. So right now we don't have it yet, but we are building that. So eventually it'll be to where we can actually have conversations. You'll have representatives on to actually communicate with you and kind of help if you're looking for a little bit of help, if you're just going on to just ask some questions or different things like that.
Well, that's later on. My web, you finna get into it right then, ladies and gentlemen. We want to get the phone number, your booking phone number, once again.
And the booking phone number is 850-293-2063.
All right, Jazzy Red. And I'm knowing behind it, you know, I don't like to film folk with their folks in. Tell them that. She, this is not the last time we're going to interview her, ladies and gentlemen. I just wanted to touch base and let you meet Lady Ebony because she was on my show and she stayed in front of my camera, walking in front of my camera, too. But that made me remember you. I told Mr. Sotomayor, I said, look, we got to get her, you know, and you're going to thank the man. What is his name?
Yes, Frankie Stoudemire. Of course I have to thank him.
All right. That is Peggy Scott Adams' brother, and we're going to interview him in a little bit. Jazzy Red, we're going to tell him God bless you.
God bless you guys.
All right. She was like that. Lady Ebony. Jazzy Red Talk Show. Get over there with that button. We're going to see grandbaby, and he can walk, and he's 9 months. Come here, Caden. Come here. Come here, say hey, grandmammy. Hey, Jazzy Red. We love you. Peace out. He trying to run for you. Come on, Caden. Come on, Caden. Yay. There he is. 9 months walking. Yay. Trying to touch that light. You bad, man. Go on where your mommy at. Hey, grandbaby. Hey, grandbaby. Hey, grandbaby. I wanted you all to see my grandbaby. And that's the other one running behind him. But he's 9 months old. 9 months old and walking. Hey, Caden, look at him. He's so happy. Praise you, Lord. Amen. Jazzy Red, we love you. Peace out. Jazzy Red Talk Show, you know, I hadn't told you all a great book, but this is a good read. I hadn't told you about a book in a long time. This is Common. Common is a rapper, okay? The name of his book is One Day It'll All Make Sense. It's by Common with Adam Bradley. Now, let me tell you what really, it's a memoir. He said his father kidnapped him and his mother. he would be okay. His dad would be okay. That was after they had broke up. The dad would be okay until he got to drinking and drugging. This is really a good read. He handcuffed his mom to the steering wheel. His dad did. And his dad's side of the story said it. His mom said she wanted something for a headache. So after he handcuffed his mom to that steering wheel, he went in there and got those aspirins. She some kind of way got out of those handcuffs and pulled all them aspirins in his coke. So when they did get to the hotel, he was knocked out. And that's how they got away. One other story that touched my heart in this book, because you know Jazz read a lot. This really touched me. This young man told about Emmett Till. You know, his mom was a school teacher, so she taught Carmen a lot. She was a principal, too. So she taught him about Emmett Till. And he said one day he was running under a stadium, running real fast, and it was dark. And Emmett Till, it was his spirit. He seen him. He did not say anything. He had his hat on and showed that gold teeth. He had a smile in his. And it's like he was telling Carmen, You make a difference. Be a purpose. Do something for a purpose and keep going. And this man is so blessed. He's blessed right now. You young people know Common. I know he's an actor, but I didn't know he was a rapper. And he's got a book. So you all has got to get the book. Maya Angelou said, a magnificent memoir. So I want you to go out and get Common's book. One day, it'll all make sense. Gentlemen, it is so, it's real nice. Sometimes you have to take your kids over by the water and just let them see the water. Amen.
Go ahead.
We're by the water.
I love
crawfish.
Here's the water.
My grandbaby loved crawfish. I got to go to the shipyard, but we are letting him see the water. He liked the water. See? You don't have to spend a lot, do you? Tell him you like crawfish. Grandmama got to buy you some crawfish. So Grandmama got to buy me some crawfish. Tell him.
Granny bought me some crawfish.
Yeah, I said, peace out.
Peace out.
You see how the kids like the water, ladies and gentlemen. I'm right here with him now. He ain't going no farther, but I bring him over here and let him see the water. Sometime we had to let the kids see water and see the bridge. And I love taking my sick and my shed in somewhere, you know. You can fish here. It is so nice. Carteria's like the water. He cried the last time. And I told him I ain't gonna bring him back if he cried, because we couldn't stay long. I just wanted you to see that you don't have to spend a lot of money. You can take kids somewhere, and right here in Mobile, you can take them on the Bayway, and they have a wheelchair ramp, so you can bring the sick and you can bring them out here, man. They got a wheelchair. You can bring them out here. This is their ramp. Bring them out here and let them see this water. It is so nice. They also have one that just want to walk out. That's for the grown folk there. You know, I guess. But you can bring them out here and they can see the water. It don't take a lot of money to have some fun in Mobile. Jazzy Red, we love you. Peace out.
Go ahead. Say, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
This is a boat.
This is a boat.
Point at the boat.
Point at the boat.
Let me talk.
Carteria's wanted to show my viewers a boat. Chris Craft, this is a boat here. This is what a boat looked like, little young ladies and little girls. And we're over by the Felix Fish Camp. We're by the Felix Fish Camp. Y'all know Jazz get a little tongue-tied sometime. I'll be tired. We're at the Phyllis Boat Camp. This is what a boat looked like. I wanted to show the kids a boat. All right.
I know it.
It's all right. He said, Granny, you stepping in water. I said, I got on my tennis shoes. I wanted them to see a boat. Isn't this nice? Isn't this nice? This is so nice. And they got something up in that boat, making it look like something. Isn't that something?
Yeah.
Yeah. You like that? Yeah. Jezred, we love you. Peace out. Jezred Talk Show, and y'all, now kids, y'all see a boat. See what you can do when you grow up? Look at that. They're showing you how they pull a boat out of the water. This is so nice. I just wanted y'all to catch a boat before I pull off the pier, and we got one. And they're finna pull a boat out of the water. Oh, look at that. Oh, it is so nice. See, kids, when you grow up, you're going to get you a boat and you'll come out and fish. You'll be able to bring other kids out where they'll be able to fish. See, we just pass it on. That's all it is. Pass it on. Jezred, we love you. And they finna pull this boat on out of here. All right. You got to be a professional to ride on the boat. And while they pulling it out, you got to be professional to do that. We're going to see if I can get them to say a little something. Jezred, peace.
All right, yeah.
Tell them something about crab.
Well, we go out and we run traps every morning, commercial traps. And we hope that we get a bunch of crabs. This morning we did pretty good. We got a business down in Bayman out of our own that we sell them out of. And so this is his first year crabbing. I've been doing it for a while, so I'm just kind of teaching him how to do it so he can take over and I can pretty much stay at the shop.
So you got a shop?
Yes, ma'am.
How that go? You a free commercial? Tell him.
Well, we're located in...
Get that microphone up there.
We're located in Baymanette, Alabama, just about a quarter mile south of the community college down there. And we sell everything Gulf seafood. Everything crab, shrimp, crawfish, fish, live catfish, and stuff cooked to order.
Get that mic up a little bit. Give him the phone number.
Phone number is going to be 251-947-34727.
Say it again.
947-27. What is it? I don't remember our phone number.
Give him that phone number.
Go ahead.
Let him tell.
Phone number is 251.
Come on with that mic. Give him that.
Yeah.
Phone number is 251-4727.
All right, you going to show him a crab?
Yeah.
All right.
I can get him out of here without him trying to get a hold of me.
What kind of crabs are these?
Those are blue claw crabs.
Oh, look at that, kids. You're able to see crabs now. God. Oh. Jezred wanna
thank these men for showing us crabs and let me see them. We're going to get their phone number where we can run it across the screen about they been. All right. See, Jez always meeting people. All right. Jezred, we love you. Peace out. What, you finna give him a card? All right. My grandbaby got a card. And he finna give him the car. That's a businessman there. All right, Jezred. It is poor man's. All right, poor man's is 251-937. Stand over there, bam, grandbaby. Stand over there, bam. We've got a, we connect, get over closer to him. We got poor man, there you go. We got poor man's, and it is 251-937. And they are down in Bartlett. All right, we're going to put them out there. The number will be running across the screen. All right, look at my other grandbaby. You want to walk over there? This is so nice. Now we've met some friends where we can buy some crab. Walk on over there, Caden. Walk over there, Caden. There go my grandbaby. He go. We connecting today. We connecting. He want to walk off now. Jezred, we love you. Y'all going to come out and support poor man's seafood. Things happen for a reason. God is good. All right, Jezred Talk Show. Upon leaving out, I met someone I know, but they didn't want to get on camera. You know, they ain't dressed. But I told them dressing ain't about nothing. We out here trying to put a show together. This is how they come out to relax. You put the meat in this crab net, and the crabs come at it, kids. This how you catch crabs. You have a crab net. Yeah, see that? Okay, now what's the purpose of the string?
Securing your meat, so if it's more than a crab out there, it doesn't take your meat.
Okay, I ain't got nothing but your... Everywhere I want to get on, so I got your hand. So you secure the meat?
Yes, ma'am. And sometimes not only that, we have confronted an alligator out here or two.
Oh, no, an alligator. But y'all brave, man, because I like the guy's face there. I'm getting nothing but his hand. So they getting ready to crab. This is going to be so much fun. And they're going to throw it out. And y'all just throw the meat out there, huh? They'll throw the meat and they hope something will come. But they say one time a alligator come. Okay, I definitely don't want one of them. And we definitely don't want to get no visitors from that. But they have a net, so the crab will bite on it, and you pull it in. God, I didn't know you do that. I thought you put the... Oh, sometimes you have to tell them you have to get in the water.
A crab is really sneaky. You can pull it so far when it sees you and let go.
A crab is smart. So we learning that the crabs are smart. Okay, so when the crab bite on the meat, you pull it in, and then you put it in the... Okay, let's show that. Hold that down. All right, they put the meat out there, and then the crab get in there, and they put it inside of there. Oh, boy, y'all enjoying y'allself. Oh, okay, she put them and dump them in there, she said she afraid of. But she's out here supporting her hubby. This is something nice. You like this, Carter? Carter, you like this? Huh? All right. You like it? All right. We're learning something today. Jazz Red out here before she go to work. Ain't this something? Now, y'all know I'm too old for this. But they done throw this out. I mean, you can enjoy yourself on this bayway. Don't forget about Mobile has some great waters. Come out and just enjoy yourself here. Jazz Red, we love you. Uh-oh, there go a boat. Uh-oh, Jazz will see a boat. Jazz will see a boat out there. Jazz Red, we love you. Sure, and we're here at English Barber and Style. English Barber and Style. And this is where my grandbaby get his hair cut. We're going to go inside and show the after effects, but let me give you the phone number to English Barber and Style. It is 251-391-7332. Their address is 1211B Martin Luther King Avenue. And for the old school, y'all know that's where I grew up at. The old Davis Avenue is Martin Luther King Jr. Avenue. And we're going to go inside and we're going to show my grandbaby's hair. It's his birthday, so we're getting his hair cut. All right. The phone number is 251-391-7332. These young men can cut your hair. They do a great job. I'm going to show you my grandbaby in a little bit. Jazz Red Talk Show. We just giving you, hey, man, hey, when I'm in here filming, you have to be quiet, man. All right, look, we in here, and your name Tyrone. Y'all going to have to call Tyrone. You know that's a nice song, but we showing you he is really doing this. This is what he doing. The kids let him just cut the hair, and, man, he be cutting with a passion. One time I told him, I said, wait a minute now, you taking long. He said, I got to make sure this right, Red. This is the way I cut. So he be cutting with a passion. I wanted to put some music with him. Y'all have got to come out to give him the name of the, what's the name of it?
English Barbershop. It's 1211 BMLK Avenue, 36603. Phone number 391-7332.
What days?
2 through Saturdays from 9 to 6.
All right, y'all got to come out.
All right. Y'all got to come out and see these young men. We got a couple of them that come up here that are cut. Just come on in. Tell them you want your baby's hair cut. And they're going to do you right. Jazz Red Talk Show. And I'm going to show you a couple of heads once we get finished. Jazz Red, baby, and this is the finished product. Y'all see how he looking. We want to say happy birthday to Carteris. Today is his birthday. So, Grandma, I'm going to take you to Walmart game. All right, I got to go to Walmart. You want to tell him hello? All right, tell him hello. All right. Jazz Red and her grandbaby are day out with him. He got his hair cut. Now we're going to Walmart. See, I ain't getting no big birthday party. That be y'all parents doing that stuff, man. You ain't able? Just take them over there across the bay and have a picnic. They'll like that. Town.com. This is where you can book to have your wedding reception, your parties, your cabarets, your red carpet. But you call Jazz Red to come do your red carpet, okay? I come out here and put the red carpet out here. Let me give you the phone number. This is in Mobile, Alabama. 251-433-7920. You have got to come and call him and check out the downtown temple. Everybody said we want to know where we can give a party. This is a big place. It is so big I'd have to scan back to try to, I'm zooming in, but I can't zoom back. It is so big. You have got to come here. It's cold, it's ice cold, and they're going to treat you right. Now, we've told you about the downtown temple, and I've given you that. The phone number is 251-433-7920. Now we're going to tell you what they're having there. Jazz Red, we love you. Peace out. Jazz Red, we've got a jazz festival, and we've got a friend of mine going to sit here and tell you what's going on and what she got. Peace out. Jazz Red Talk Show, and I'm here with a friend of mine. And I'm about, you know, it's technicalities on Jazz Red Show. We're here at the temple downtown. She's going to tell you what she got going on. And I'm going to want you all to come out and check this jazz festival out. Tell them what's going on.
We're at the temple downtown, and this is the home place of the Gulf Coast Ethnic and Heritage Jazz Festival. The festival will occur on August the 1st, and it'll be held at the temple downtown, 351 St. Francis Street, corner of Claiborne and St. Francis. We are going to start this thing around 2 p.m. in the afternoon and go from 2 to 10, and I'll tell you who we have. We have the E.B. Coleman Orchestra. And we have Gino Rosario. Gino is from Caracas, and he's Latin, and he'll give you a little Latin jazz. After that, we have the Mobile Blues Boy, Jamel Richardson. You know, Jamel won the 92 Zoo contest for the Hangout Festival. So he is awesome. He is awesome. He's bluesy jazzy. Also, we have Eddie Shaw of the Old Howlin' Wolf Band, and he'll have his group here, Eddie Shaw and the Wolf Gang. Okay, so we're throwing in a little blues this year in honor of B.B. King. You know, B.B. King just passed away, our great blues legend, and we want to honor him. Also, we are inducting Marcus Johnson, who passed away in December of 2014. We are honoring him, and we are inducting Marcus into our Jazz Hall of Fame. So we have a lot going on. We'll have indoor activities and outdoor activities. The street will be blocked off here in front of the temple, and we'll have a stage and bands outside and inside. The inside at the temple, the show is $10. The outside street fest is free. So we'll have vendors, artists, bands, and everything. So you can come out, bring your coolers. You can bring your, we will have food trucks outside for your convenience, but you can bring your coolers or your food or whatever. It'll be one grand picnic, but it'll be indoors if you want your picnic indoors. It'll be outdoors if you want your picnic outdoors. Okay, Gulf Coast Ethnic and Heritage Jazz Festival, August 1st, 2 to 8 p.m.
Well, you got a phone number for them to get in touch with you?
Yes, they can contact the Jazz Festival at 251-478-4027.
Now, Jazz got to throw this in. Now, this is my lawyer, and she had represented me, and I use some lawyers in Mobile locally because we got some good lawyers. Tell them your phone number for your business, because I got to come prorate my will. I got to do my will.
Okay. Okay. The business number, 458-3860. 458-3860. Or you can call the same number as for the Jazz Festival, 478-4027. Okay, we are there to serve you.
All right. Y'all got to come out. Y'all come out and patronize. Now, on Thursday night, Jazz can't be here because I'm at the shipyard. So somebody take me out the shipyard. I might can do a little more. All right?
But this is a Saturday night, August 1st. Saturday night.
Okay, I done got it mixed up. So night,
August 1st, Saturday during the day and at night. So you just come on out and have a full day of it.
Okay, this is a full day. Can they bring the kids on the outside?
Of course. Right, we are very kid-friendly.
All right. Jazz Red, we love you. That number is running across the screen. Call my lawyer. Let's get this thing going and come down to the temple downtown. All right, Jazz Red, tell them God bless you and come on out.
God bless you. We'll be looking for you. And hey, come on out here now. Don't slow down on us. Just come on out. Okay. All right.
Stand where you at. Jazz Red Talk Show. I'm behind these important dignitaries here. We're going to hope that camera ain't swung around. Look like it did. We're going to let them tell you what they got going on. Tell them your name. Here. Tell them your name. You done been on before now.
We're celebrating the original Donna Bay reunion, where we bring back people that was raised down in this area. We bring them back so we can meet. Sometimes we don't see each other for maybe 10 or 15 years. Some kind of way, they venture back to Mobile, Alabama.
Okay, and who you got next week?
This is my son, Dr. Albert Russell, from Montgomery, Alabama.
Don't put me on the spot like that.
Tell him, get the mic.
I'm from down the bay, and most of the people you meet out here are from down the bay, but it's not limited. You know, we just having a celebration for everybody. This started across the street from Pullman's Bakery in that field where that church, it was a church there now, but it used to be an empty lot. And we started out right there with the same concept, a grill, some music, and all the people from down the bay coming back and getting back together. So.
And it started in the 90s, you said.
Yeah,
right?
started in the 90s. I was still a high school student.
Yeah.
And I'll be 40 in September, so that was a long time ago.
Mm-hmm. And it's free food?
Free food.
Nothing sold, everything
nothing
free.
Nothing sold.
That's
we
right.
We raise money through the year.
Through the year?
Yeah, we raise money through the year. We have a lot of people that donate religiously to make sure that when the people come, they don't have to spend any money.
Oh, man, that is so nice. Well, what we going to do, you've got a wife that got a book.
I do.
We're going to put her on. She's going to tell about the book. Yeah, we're going to put her on. And what we're going to do, I want to thank y'all for this interview. But
we're
going to interview his wife with this book. Tell him God bless you.
God bless you. Peace.
God bless you.
Jazz Red Talk Show. We finna interview a little lady. Her, the name of her book is Divine Forgiveness, and it's by Dr. Tamika D. Russell. We got a lady that's a doctor. We finna interview her. Jazz Red, peace out. No, hit it again. It's a record. I can't see that red light. It usually be a red light. I guess the sun is out. Okay, it's recording. We're here with Dr. Tamika D. Russell. Tell them, my viewer, wait a minute, what inspired you to write?
I've loved to write ever since I was a little girl. Writing poetry actually helped to relieve anxiety in me. But my first book was released in 2008, Sanctified and Still Standing. God told me that I needed to write that book in order to encourage young ladies who felt like life was too difficult for them to accomplish their dreams. And so my first book was actually my personal testimony. Okay. And then while I was deployed to Iraq, God gave me
wait
the vision.
You've been in the service?
I did 7 years in the Air Force, yes, ma'am.
Oh, look at what we got. A doctor, and she's also a war lady. She's been in the service. We got a service lady here. Wait a minute. You've been in the service?
Yes, ma'am.
So you know the left flank and the right flank and the bow face. See, I remember all that from ROTC. I ain't go there. We want to talk a little bit about your book. Tell me what this book, Divine Forgiveness, tell me a little bit about it. I'm going to hold it for you.
So for the second book, God wanted me to deal with the topic of forgiveness. I think forgiveness is one of the most difficult things for us as Christians to extend. And, you know, Jesus forgave us in the most amazing way possible by laying down his life while we were yet sinners. And so this book deals with, you know, divine forgiveness, which a lot of times when somebody hurts you so deeply that you can't even fathom forgiving them, okay, that forgiveness has to come from the Holy Spirit. And that's what this book is about. It's about a young lady, Deanna, who's actually from Mobile.
Okay.
So I did include Mobile
in this book. You gotta get this book.
And it talks about some things that happened to her in her past, and she had a hard time grasping, you know, what happened when she finally found out, like, how things came about. Okay. And God had to help her to forgive this person that hurt her so deeply.
That hurt her so deeply. So it's about forgiveness.
It is.
Okay, we want to get a phone number. Give us a phone number where we can get your book.
Okay, so the book is actually available on Amazon.com. Okay. So if you go on Amazon, right now it's available in Kindle form, but in the next 2 to 3 weeks, it will be available in paperback copy, and the cost of the book is $15.99.
$15.99. That is not a bad price for a very great book. Service lady, and she married a homeboy from Mobile, down the bay. So we have got to get this book. We've got to patronize with her. I appreciate you for the interview and divine forgiveness. We got to get that book. Jazzy, tell them God bless.
God bless you, and thank you.
All right, Jazzy, we love you. Peace out. Girl, you a service lady. Lord, have mercy. Jazzy Talk Show, just to show you, the kids are getting ready to crank up. Here's the water. Donovan is the young man, and Genesis is the little lady there. And they're enjoying themselves. This park is so nice, man. They got food. They got, you name it, they got junk. Oh, she's spitting at her brother. And your dad is here seeing you. Jazzy Red, we love you with the babies. We love them to have fun. Clean fun. Peace out.
We're here at the Down the Bay reunion, hanging out with Jazzy Red and the unofficial mayor of Down the Bay, Brother Moon. Brother Moon, tell him about yourself.
Better known as Moon Johnson. Hey, why don't I get my check on the first?
Hey, man, come out.
Hey.
Come
on here, man. Hey, better known as Moon Johnson.
Uh-huh.
And y'all welcome down to Miss Russell get together, because we're going to have some fun today. And y'all need to come on down and have a good time, because I'm going to have me a good time today.
That's
amen.
Right.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Jazzy Red Talk Show, and we got a man out here on the grill. He going to tell you a little something about himself. Look at that meat he got thrown on there. So that's the Chef Moyon. He going to tell you a little something about himself.
Larry Green out of Huntsville, here down in lovely Mobile, celebrating the Down the Bay reunion. Just got a little something on the grill from my mother-in-law. They're trying to make it as special as I can for all the folks here in Mobile. I'm always glad to be down here. Feel like you want to taste a little something, come on out here and enjoy one of these hot dogs, hamburgers. And a little later, we're going to have what every black man loves to cook, and that's some good old baby back short ribs, baby. Come on down and join us. God bless you, and hope you have a wonderful day. And to all my veterans out there, like myself, happy 4th of July.
Jazzy Red Talk Show, we got an important dignitary here, and we're going to let him tell you his name and what he do.
Good afternoon. I'm LaVon Manson, and I represent District 2 on the Mobile City Council. Happy to be out here for the original Down the Bay reunion. I hope that everyone has a happy 4th of July, celebrating our independence and the freedoms and democracies that we have here in this country. So I hope all of you enjoying your day, and happy to be here with residents from Down the Bay. God bless you.
Bay at Texas Street. But I think this is the 2000 and some reunion, and we do it every other year. We are like everybody to come out, not next year, but the next year, able to have you out here. This is Deborah Bindow, my great-grandbaby, Dion, and Miss Nita Lewis, and the DJ is Joe Nathan, her son. So everybody, come on out and enjoy yourself. If you don't come this year, not next year, the other year. We have it every other year at Texas Street Park. We got things going on. They got the sprinkle for the kids, the space walker. We feed them. We enjoy them. It's this good environment. Non-violent. Thank you.
Thank you.
Say hey, happy 4th of July. Say happy 4th of July.
All right, baby. Jazzy Red, we out here. She done said it all. Jazzy Red, we love you. Peace out.
My name is Quinlan Daffin, and I'm one of the best. And first of all, I just want to thank God for another day that wasn't promised to me. And I want to say happy 4th of July to everyone in Mobile, Alabama. This is Mr. Daffin. I'm one of the best.
All right. Okay. Jazz Red Talk Show. Tell them God bless
you. And God bless you.
And I Jazz Red Talk Show. We got the DJ here. The music is loud, but I know my mic is bringing it on through. This brother going to tell you his name and give you the phone number.
All right, baby. I'm DJ Joe Nathan from Down the Bay, a.k.a. Maysville. We kicking in that Texas Reaper Down the Bay Union. You see the shirt, baby. Don't let it be scared, baby, all night, baby, all day. We have a DJ Joe Nathan. My name is Jonathan Lewis. I'm from Down the Bay. And my phone number, in case you want to book me, is 250-508-4082. Don't you forget it.
All right, he's got a lot of sounds, all the old, the new. He do remixes. Y'all got to give him a call. Give him that phone number one more time.
251-508-4082. Call me. Night, day, earth, wind, and fire, whatever, baby. Give me a call, baby.
Jazz Red Talk Show upon me, pulling out with all these good people. I haven't really enjoyed myself today. It has been so nice. With Miss Big D and Mr. Red, and I don't know the other man over there, but I just wanted to scan a little bit and tell y'all they're having a night for 4th of July. Good, clean fun. Jazz of Red, we love you. Peace out. Jazz of Red Talk Show, I wanted you all to see this hat. Just check this hat out. You have to be fashionable at the Down the Bay reunion here. Isn't that a sharp hat? And they told me you was a majorette, sis. Yeah, they told me you was a majorette. All right. Jazz Red. The head majorette for Central. All right now. Y'all gonna. Well, I sure hate it, Jazz Red. Jazz Red Talk Show, and look what we got. Look at him. Baby, can't nobody do it like the Down the Bay folk. Look at him. Look up top there. Now we're gonna let this man tell you his name. Tell him your name
there, buddy. Hello. Alabama. That's my wife sitting. And this is the queen here.
Beneath our paradise. This is where I want to live my life. Up in the sky. When I die. Yeah, as you born. See the soul, boy. See the soul. Wanna walk the street paved with gold, chop it up with the angels, effing to me go, and then rejoice with my family and friends. Cause we gon' party, cause it won't be no end. I'ma bounce with it. 12 days in the city, no flesh, nobody, it'll all be spirit. I look to meet my grandmama, my granddad, and my auntie Ruby. We're all stars, starring in God, holy movie. The author, producer, creator, Jehovah. It's a Hollywood blockbuster, title of the movie. Eternal life and ice, our paradise with Christ. True story will be the light. No more dark nights, every day will be bright. No more dark nights, every day will be light. No more nights, hereby I say, we coming to the seventh day. Rejoicing the I stop paradise every day. Meet my ancestors from back up in the day. I wanna keep a G up there in peace and perfect harmony. Drop a track, write some poetry with Big Tupac and Pimp C. Let Mahalia Jackson drop me a hook, marinated with a little bit of Sam Cooke. No more dirty looks, no more crooks. These will be the last books, final books of the books. Make a drop of north on the top of your lungs. No more death, ash to ash and dirt to dirt. It's the rebirth. God relocated us in heaven from planet Earth.
And I stop paradise. This is where I wanna live when I die. I'm gonna walk the streets and stay with gold way beyond the sky. And I stop paradise. This is where I'm gonna live when I die. I wanna walk the streets and stay with gold and chill with Jesus Christ. I wanna see the man who died for me on Calvary.
Been looking like a star. Hey, baby, turn me up, DJ. I'm jamming with the late great Jamaster J. Billie Holiday came my way in a red dress. I was blessed to see so many people from back up in the day. Ray Charles, Johnny Taylor, old is ready, sitting on the dock of the bay. A little left, I murdered Monroe. Laughing at Red Fox, drinking champagne with my dead Uncle Monroe. Holla at Pedo, holla at Paul, holla at my daddy's too bald. I want me bald, chopping up with my dog, just to name a few. Jake and Timothy, Matthew, Tupac Shakur, every present with them blue suede shoes. Screw it up, chopping up with DJ Screw, King David, John the Baptist, Abraham, Moses, Megan, Ever, no more danger, no more stranger. My house, my home, big old mansion in the paradise. It won't be in the midst of strangers. I'll be around the throne with God and the holy angels. In my father's house, there are many mansions. I hope I am chosen. I hope I got a seat in them. I hope to see you in them. No more black or white racism. We'll all be one religion. Christianity, Buddhism, Muslim. All in that new Jerusalem. Gave a blowing trumpet. It sounded like 415 is what I'm thumping.
Across this nation, I never die. I live through y'all forever.
May the life I live speak for me. The only thing they can say about C, he laid it down like a G. As the world spin, back it up and bring it back again. I got some friends throwing up them sets in the 5, in the 6. I got the Jesus piece on the crucifix. As the world turn, as the world tick, I ain't asked for this. I'm too legit, so I can't quit until I rest in peace and drop the hits.
Let's make this a night to remember.
Celebration tonight. Oh my.